Bishop chapter 6. Now Jericho was shut inside and outside because of the people of Israel. None went out and none came in. And the Lord said to Joshua, "See, I have given Jericho into your hand, with its kings and mighty men of valor. You shall march around the city, all the men of war, going around the city once. Thus shall you do for 6 days.
7 weeks shall bear 7 trumpets of ram horns before the ark. On the 7th day, you shall march around the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow the trumpets. And when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, when you hear the sound of trumpets, then all the people shall shout with a great shout. And the wall of the city will fall down flat. And the people shall go up, everyone straight before him." So Joshua, the son of Nun, called the priest and said to them, "Take up the ark of the covenant and let 7 priests bear 7 trumpets and ram's horn before the ark of the Lord."
And he said to the people, "Go forward, march around the city, and let the armed men pass on before the ark of the Lord." And just as Joshua had commanded the people, the 7 priests bearing the 7 trumpets of ram's horns before the Lord went forward, blowing the trumpets with the ark of the covenant of the Lord following them. The armed men were walking before the priests who were blowing the trumpets, and the rear guard was walking after the ark. While the trumpets blow continually.
But Joshua commanded the people, "You shall not shout or make your voice heard, neither you shall any word go out in your mouth until the day I tell you, shall then you shall shout." So he crossed the ark of the Lord and circled the city, going about one, and they come into the camp to spend the night in the camp. Then Joshua rose early in the morning, and the priest took out in the
each with the edge of the sword. But to the two men who had spied out the land, Joshua said, "Go into the prostitute's house and bring out from there the woman and all who belong to her, as you swore to her." So the young man who had been spies went in and brought out Rahab and her father and mother, and brothers and all who belonged to her, and he brought all her relatives and put them outside the camp of Israel. And they burned the city with fire and everything in it, only the silver and gold and the vessels of bronze and of iron they put into the treasury of the house of the Lord. But Rahab, the prostitute, and her brother's household, and all who belonged to her, Joshua saved her life.
In chapter 6 is very well-known story. Joshua and Israel, they march around the city, Jericho. And the Christians, they used to sing about this story, the Jericho and Joshua. Actually, Jericho means Moon City. And the historian, they found that this city, Moon City, means this is worship. Worship for idol. This is the center for worship at the Moon City, the Jericho. So we guess God, He commanded Israel, they destroy this the city absolutely, because Genesis and also Deuteronomy, God, He told them, the Israel, in the land of Canaan, there are lots of idols. And Israel, they must be careful to follow idolatry in Canaan. So the God says, you destroy the city Jericho. And actually, this Jericho is like a curse. The city to destroy, to conquer, so we know this story, the Jericho absolutely falls, destroyed. How? How? The story does not focus on, is not focus on Joshua's leadership. The focus is not Joshua's good leadership, and the people's power. The purpose is that God, He alone, He conquered this city Jericho. In verse 1, Verse 1 says, the situation is the Jericho was shown inside, outside, because of people of Israel. Not them going and out and coming in. Nobody was done. Why? They knew that who is Israel. Maybe they heard the Israelite and the Jehovah, Yahweh God, is very mighty. And they are afraid of this Israel. So they shut the door and nobody going out and coming in. Which means this situation is very hard. And the historian, they said, this city is not a very big city, but one of all these very old the city. And they also measure this city is almost 600 meters about 20 minutes they can march around. Not very big city. The problem is, if they close the gates, it's not easy to conquer. And God says, what they have to do is, we know their hope, how to conquer this city. 6 days, they march around. One day, one time, go around, and seventh day, seven times. Then, blow the trumpet, then shout. What do you think? It is easy or hard? Just one day, one time, marching. The problem is, verse 10, don't talk. Do you know the character of Israel? Israel, do you remember Israel's their major in the wilderness? Very talkative. Complain. Always complain. Why no water? Why no food? They easily complain. They always talking. But God says, don't talk. Just marching. Maybe it's very hard. They want to. And then maybe inside the city or the army or Jacob, maybe they just scolding and they blame what they are doing now. Maybe they want to say something, but God said, don't talk, just marching every day. They need faith. They need only faith. You know, if you read verse 2, and the Lord said to Joshua, see, I have given Jericho into your hand. Before they start this fight, before they start conquer this city, God already informed them, I have given this city into your hand. What does it mean? victory is already given to Israel. They know already. This is victory. God says, I have given this city into your hands. You know, this is like our fight. The Christian, our fight. Our fight of our faith is, we know already our victory because of Jesus Christ. Our ultimate consequence, result is victory. We know, Christian, we know our ending, victory. We know, victory is there. We eventually, ultimately, we will encounter victory. But what we have to do is faith, faith. Actually, Hebrews 11:30. Hebrews chapter 11. Chapter 11, verse 13. Climax of this story, so most of the people, they just remember, oh, the climax is that seventh day. The city of Jericho just fell down. You know, we most of the people, they think, oh, this is the climax. But if you read today, chapter 6, verse 20, verse 20 says, so the people shouted and the trumpet were blown. As soon as the people heard the sound of trumpet, the people shouted a great shout and the wall fell down flat, so that the people went up into the city. Every man slayed before him and they captured the city. Ending is very short. The Bible just briefly explained. Just one verse, one verse. Climax is not fall of city of Jericho. The Bible do not explain long about ending. What? Only one verse, only one verse. But climax is not ending, but climax is processing. What does it mean? This one chapter explain in details about how they obey God's word. Process, not result. Climax is process, how they faith and obey the God's word patiently. If you read Deuteronomy chapter 20, actually Deuteronomy chapter 16 to 18. 1, 2, 3. For in the cities of this people that the Lord your God is giving you for inheritance, you shall set aside nothing but bread. For you shall be open to the complete destruction. But in your eyes, in your lives, in your hands, in your sides, and in the eyes of your sides, as the Lord your God has commanded. If you read today chapter 6, the God reminds them, you destroy these people all. Like the verse 17, the city and all that is within it shall be devoted to the Lord for destruction. All. You destroy them all. You kill them all. You know, the purpose that Israel enter this land is not to be just rich. Once again, the purpose that Israel they enter this land is not to be prosperous and rich. That's not purpose. Why God allow them enter this land? To be rich? God wants the Israel, His people, they have wide fellowship with God, even in this land. God's purpose is not only we, the people of God, after we are saved, we become rich, we become healthy. That's not ultimate goal. After we are saved, after we become Christian, we have more wide fellowship with God, relationship with God. That's what God says. Deuteronomy chapter 20. You destroy them all, and you obey, listen my word. Even conquer this land, God requires just faith, obey my word. So all the people destroyed. You watch the video, the reason why God allowed the people of Israel destroy all the Canaanites. God does not enjoy killing the people. But I already explained why. From the Genesis, God already shared the people in the Canaan, they have a lot of sins and they deserve destruction because of their evil and because of their sin. So God judged these people. Not only killing these people, but that's the judge. God judged evil sin. Absolutely. But except for whom? God destroyed all, but except one family. Who's that? Love. Verse 17 and verse 22. 7. The city all the ways is given devoted to the Lord for destruction. Only Lama, the prostitute, all who are with her in her house shall live. God destroyed all. But at the same time, God rescued one family. Because of one woman. Because of one woman. This is amazing because of one woman. Like because of one man, Adam, all men, we became sinners. We deserve judgment of God, punishment of God. We all deserve judgment of God. But because of one man, Jesus Christ, we have the way to be saved because of one man. In the end, these old cities, all the things in the world will be destroyed. If you read Revelation, there is a Babylon, the big city. The Babylon is the symbol of the secular world, secular authority, dominion. But in the end, all power, dominion, even great things, will be destroyed completely. Like today, the Jericho, in the end, just one verse, just gone, it will be gone. Very faster, absolutely. But like Lahab's family, who are chosen by His grace, they will endure and they will tolerate all. We are saved already, and in the end, God, He will save us in the destruction of His secular world. That's the only grace of God. We people of God, we need faith. Faith patiently and continually. That's the only way. Not our Father, thank you for your election. Like Laha, she compares who you are, Redeemer, Savior, Lord. We also confess, Lord, you alone, true God, and Jesus Christ is the Lord and Savior and Mediator. You saved us from our sin, Lord. In the end, you will save us in the destruction of this world. We need faith with the patient endurance. Not only a moment, every day, every moment, we need faith in your grace. Although we do not see victory, success with our eyes every time, we know that our ultimate ending, ultimate victory in our life because of Jesus Christ. That's why, Lord, you help us to faith in you. Fix our eyes on you, to turn to you, to look to you continually, not to to see only troubles and worries and darkness. We want to see you. In Jesus' name I pray.